What's going on, Black Pillars? Haven't been here in a while. Just wanted to drop a video on you. Something I came across a while back. It adds to a lot of the information that is being hidden from us. And I kind of believe that the video I'm about to show you pertaining to the lost city of Atlantis and the possible location of it. And this guy presents an extremely good argument. And you'll be shocked at where the city of Atlantis could possibly be. But you know me, I have to put my own little stank on the video. So check out the video. I'm gonna drop the link to this guy's video. Give him a follow. Really good guy. Very meticulous in his investigations, and easy to listen to, and he explains it thoroughly. So check this guy out and tell me what you think. I'll holler at you.
The fucking lesson comes, the sundial speaks.
Man, verbalize what time is it?
The building of the strong are the lessons of the meek.
Man, verbalize what time is it?
My science is deep, my blackness is deep.
How deep?
Deep, deeper than Atlantis.
My first two videos on the topic of the lost city of Atlantis, I connected the dots on more than a dozen similarities between Plato's description of Atlantis to that of the Rikot structure, which is commonly referred to as the Eye of the Sahara and is located in a remote region of northwest Africa in the country of Mauritania. And my argument in those videos was that these similarities are so numerous and so precise that the Rikot structure should be considered as the most likely location for this lost ancient civilization. However, nothing is certain, and it is undoubtedly the subject of much debate. But if after watching those first two videos, you still doubted the possibility that the Rikot structure could be the location of Atlantis, well, in this video, I'm gonna share with you some new details that I just came across that makes the case that the Eye of Africa is not just the most likely location of Atlantis, but the connection of these added details I'm about to share makes this case so compelling that it's practically definitive. So let me jump right into these details, and afterwards I'll connect the dots on everything so we can see exactly what we're dealing with here. Like I stated in my first video, the legend of Atlantis originates from the ancient Egyptians, and the Greek lawmaker Solon recorded this information while visiting Egypt some 2,600 years ago, and the information was passed down through six generations to Plato, who published the account of Atlantis in the Timaeus and Critias dialogues some 2,400 years ago, and is apparently the only reason why we know about the legend of Atlantis today. Plato stated that the king of the capital of Atlantis was named Atlas, who was the firstborn son of Poseidon, and of course, like I mentioned before, Poseidon had 10 children through 5 sets of twins, and each one of those 10 children went on to rule each of those 10 kingdoms that made up the empire of Atlantis. Now, remember the name Atlas and hold that thought for a moment as I share something else that will connect the dots on this new information. There is a group of people that used to be referred to as the Maori. However, in modern times, they are now known as the Berber people, which inhabit a region of northwest Africa. A region once referred to as Maori, but now known as Maghreb, which essentially makes up modern-day Numidia, Morocco, West Algeria, and Mauritania. In fact, the name Mauritania comes from the Maori people. Now, does anyone happen to know the name of who was said to be the first king of Mauritania? Well, it was someone who just so happened to be named Atlas, the legendary king of the Maori people. What a coincidence. But of course, there can be no possible connection to Atlas, the king of Atlantis, because after all, there is simply no way that Atlantis could ever have been in the remote region of northwest Africa. Now hold that thought for a moment too, as I share something else with you that you've likely never seen or heard of before. There was an ancient Greek man named Herodotus who lived some 2,500 years ago, who you may be familiar with as being known as the father of history, made famous for his documentation of the Greco-Persian Wars. Herodotus was born nearly 75 years after Solon had died, and again, Solon was the person who documented the story of Atlantis from the ancient Egyptians. Herodotus himself also died when Plato was just 2 years old, so he never knew either of them, and subsequently died many years before Plato had ever published the account of Atlantis. One of Herodotus' notable achievements was developing what was then the most accurate mapping of the known inhabited world at the time of 450 BC. First, let's orient ourselves here. We can clearly see Italy, the Mediterranean Sea, the countries that surround it, the Caspian Sea, the Red Sea, the Nile Delta, to name a few notable features. And let me transition to a different version of the map so we can see things more clearly, but if you look to the left, what do you see there? That's right, the word Atlantis, which is shown to be located south of the Pillars of Hercules, or the Strait of Gibraltar, and positioned in northwest Africa. Let me first say that I do not know how or why Herodotus came to this conclusion, as this is something that I need to research more, but I look forward to any insight that people will be sharing in the comments related to his development of this map and why he claimed that Atlantis was in that specific location. You'll also notice on this map the detailing of a mountain chain just south of the Strait of Gibraltar, known today as the Atlas Mountains, which are also known to be home of the Berber people, which I mentioned earlier. And these mountains were in fact named after Atlas, the first king of Mauritania. You know, something else that's interesting to point out, when you research Atlas, the king of Mauritania, there seems to be no connection to Atlantis. I assume that this is related to the fact that nobody has ever considered that the location of Atlantis could be hiding in plain sight in the Western Sahara Desert in what is now Mauritania. Let me take a quick moment to thank John for leaving this outstanding comment, which brought the information of the first king of Mauritania, as well as Herodotus' map, to my attention, something that I was otherwise unaware of, and I suspect that goes to most everyone else watching this video. So let me clarify where we're at right now. There is a 2,500-year-old map that annotates the location of Atlantis in northwest Africa, seemingly in the exact location of the Rekot structure, and this map was created by the so-called Father of History, a trusted source of documentation praised by modern-day historians for his ability to systematically document information in vivid detail. Then we have this mysterious and incredibly unique structure in Mauritania known as the Rekot. This structure just so happens to be made of concentric circles, just as Plato had stated. But not only that, it consists of the precise amount of rings, three that would be of water and two of land. And on top of that, it just so happens to be the precise size of how Atlantis was described, measuring 23.5 kilometers or 14.5 miles across when computed in modern day measurements. It also has an opening to the south that would match Atlantis's description of connecting to the sea, and in fact, its very appearance today seems to suggest that it did. It has mountains to the north, and not only that, the mountains to the north contained rivers. The entire area surrounding the Rekot is a large level plain. The sides of Atlantis were said to be steep towards the side of the sea, and the Adrar Highlands located in this area have a steep 1,500-foot drop from cliffside to its base. Even more significantly, the center island of the Rekot produces fresh spring water, just as Plato specified, and this is despite the wells in the surrounding area producing exclusively salt water, which also is further evidence that this site was once under the ocean. The area around the Rekot has an abundance of black, red, and white color stone. And Atlantis was said to have an abundance of elephants, which elephants exist in Mauritania today, and depictions of elephants can be seen in cave art close to the Rekot structure. There are even relics including pottery shards, arrowheads, and other evidence that a civilization once lived there, yet archaeologists have no idea what civilization they belong to or when. And all of this is in Mauritania, where people who were once known as the Mori people were led by a legendary king whose name was Atlas, the same exact name as the king of Atlantis. But on top of all of this, it just so happens to be in the exact location that is annotated on an ancient map that was created by who we refer to as the Father of History.